Don't show this guy's channel name because I don't want him getting clout. Okay, wait, let me take a look at this. Oh, it's this guy. I saw this guy. Wait, he was in... This is the guy who called a cis woman trans and tried to dead name and misgender a cis woman because he thought she was trans. This is the guy, right? There, so I've never cared for, you know what. He also said he'd beat up Hassan and called for violence against justice Dems. Oh, he's insane. Good to know. Thank you. Look how like Joker brain this guy is. I forgot about this guy.
I want to give some shout outs and an update on PFC and an update on the General Strike Summit, which is coming up. That's this weekend. At least 5 INN members are going to be speaking, and myself included. I will give you guys specific times in an episode later today. I myself will be 6 p.m. Central, 7 p.m.
Eastern. Yeah, this guy is like the left-wing version. Like, unironically, this guy is the left-wing version of the quartering. I would not be surprised if this guy shat his pants or pissed in his basement. Wait, you guys have heard the quartering, like, I shat my pants story, right? It's the prequel. You haven't? No, yeah, it's the prequel to I Pissed in My Basement. Yeah, the shortening. Here, we'll watch this for a little bit and I'll go search for it. The prequel to what? You haven't, what are you talking about? What are you saying of what? Are you not in this space? Are you not connected? Are you not kept up with quartering lore? Excuse me? This is what I was so surprised when it came to Heem and Dylan, when I was on their podcast. Heem and Dylan didn't know that the quartering pissed in his basement because his wife went out for pizza without him. Like, unironically, they didn't know. I wish I wasn't up on quartering lore. I love the quartering. He's my best friend. The loitering, there you go. I was like, how the hell have you gone this far in political, like, Twitch and YouTube, and you haven't heard, I just peed in my basement.
Eastern on Saturday night, and I'm probably gonna be on a panel.
Cringe.
To be invited. And then speaking of the Vanguard, I gotta give a shout out.
He's a friend of the Vanguard? Yeah, mate, it's all coming together.
I saw this Hassan Piker bullshit go down with this morning, and they went out there and just destroyed Hassan Piker. It was really fun to watch. And see, that's what I'm talking about. Like, the Vanguard does a good job a lot of the time, even though they are hit and miss. But whenever they're acting like the Bash Brothers from Mighty Ducks, they go out there and they do just fine. They don't have to be, you know, on point with everything. As far as I know, they're not corrupt. And occasionally, when they're on, they're on. So they did a great job dismantling Hassan Piker, and that video is great. I'll put a link to it below. A lot of fun to watch. And the ratio looks great. So, I mean, that's what I'm talking about, guys. Good job.
Ratio.
So now we're going to talk about what Hassan...
I love how it comes off like fucking Donald. They talk like Donald Trump. The ratings were really good. I didn't get ratioed.
Piker said he basically belittled the General Strike Summit, and we're going to go over exactly what he said in a second. And I have a little bit of writing done. I decided to write a little song for Hassan, and I'm calling it Dueling Banjos. So you guys let me know if you like this. It's going to be a whole lot of fun, I think, to listen to. Hassan, listen closely, buddy. I just want you guys to know that this guy ain't no fucking MC. I know everything he's about to say against we. We are poor. We are fucking bums. Some of us live in trailers with our moms. We don't make millions playing video games. Nah, a big-ass mansion, that ain't part of our aims. You call yourself a socialist, but in capitalism you partook. And we all know, big brother, that there's no such thing as halfway crooks.
In capitalism you partook. Bro, no way. No way he said that shit. In capitalism you partook. Oh my gosh. Is he going to say the word fucking like sequestered in here as well? You send your e-girls after me. Oh jeez, dude. Literal Joker. Yeah, this is actually... Yeah, he's got bars.
Hasanabi means big brother, like Orwell's book. Ironic how you sit all day
inside. No, wait! No, he's doing Orwell.
With a camera on you, you childish fuck. And damn. Like your uncle, I invoke the great name of Michael Brooks, who'd be ashamed of all your rhetorical gobbledygooks.
Gobbledygook! Wow! Wait a second! Wait, he's destroying this man. Oh my goodness. I didn't know he was gonna hit him with the fucking gobbledygook, the fucking bamboozling. Oh no, the gobbledygook. So yeah, I can't, I'm sorry, I'm just like infatuated by these bars. And Meek Mill signed me. Meek Mill signed me.
Great name of Michael Brooks, who'd be ashamed of all your rhetorical gobbledygooks. Speaking of Jenk, how's that pig fucker doing?
Is that a slur? Wait, is that a slur for like please don't tell me that's a slur for like Turkish people. Please don't tell me that's a slur for Turkish people. I'm begging you, man. I'm begging you. I'll make it what I think it is. You claim to be a leftist, Hasanabi, but answer me these questions three. If I'm not satisfied with three, then cancel you will be, homie. Oh, bars. Jeepers.
Speaking of Jenk, how's that pig fucker doing, cuz? Because when we say fuck the pigs, we're actually talking about the fuzz. A general strike is when you watch my live stream, he said, as he Twitch streams all day from his king-size bed. He calls himself a hun because you're running dick first into the Great Wall. And because of all the steroids, we all know you got no balls. My man must eat almost nothing but protein powder, so much so that his framework's starting to look a lot like Steven Crowder. And pig fucker Jenk, so much so that his framework's starting to look a lot like Steven Crowder.
Damn!
And pig fucker Jenk couldn't be prouder that you're building those stacks while your takes become dumber and louder. Cool. He and Anna get rich from donations. We call that cow tipping, which is different than what Jenk does after work, which is putting his tip in a cow.
Nice. He literally just gave up. He actually just gave up and just wants to keep saying that Jenk has sex with animals. I'm sorry I said that about your uncle. Guess I let the cat out of the bag. Unlike Jenk, who keeps cats in his room for sex purposes. Okay, bud. Thank you. Appreciate
it. Pantyless Anna can't get any attention.
Whoa, now chill. Wait a second. What the fuck? What is this guy? Chill. Oh my geez. He's talking about her goddamn new skirt. Yeah, we all have a little sexual harassment as a treat, right?
Yet pantyless Anna can't get any attention, even though she's looking like a 30-year-old sow.
Wow.
Any y'all around billionaire donors, we know you're gonna drop trow and kowtow without lube like your Pramila Jayapal.
He didn't even try to rhyme like Premier Jayapal's name. Pow. Learning new words. Yeah, this is basically like, it's just straight misogyny. Oh yeah, it's like literally just straight misogyny. I mean, they are like tankies, so I mean, come on. I wouldn't be surprised. He can't hide his bigotry. We all know, yeah, we all have a pantyless Anna, right? Feel when you go so far left, you exit the screen and come back to the... Yeah, it is just, they do have a lot of, like, they are just kind of bigots.
We know you're gonna drop trow and kowtow without lube like your Pramila Jayapal.
You didn't even try to rhyme it.
Hasan Little Piggy went to Twitch stream. Hasan Little Piggy always stayed home.
Why is he always talking about animals? Really don't like this.
Hasan Little Piggy had millions while the rest of us had none. Hasan Little Piggy... Now, cry wee 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 and go all the way home to your fucking $5 million mansion. Hasan wants to be like the mountain in Game of Thrones, but we, with time, are gonna bring you down to a molehill, Holmes.
He's like, he's seething, okay? So he's trying to make it seem like he's got it together. He's literally destroying him effortlessly. Effortlessly. You know for a fact this guy was fucking crying and seething when Hasan was like, yeah, general strike isn't happening. Just chill out, guys. Just chill out. It's literally not happening. Like, you fucking. And then he's trying to figure out slurs. He was like, man, I want a slur. He's Turkish, right? Fine. Quick, Jarvis, find me Turkish slurs. He's literally just like crying, hand shaking as he was writing this out. This is just like pure cope and seething. He is literally just seething and molding here.
This name is very real.
Listen, bro, you can be upset. You can like not like Hasan. That's fine. But this level of seething is not healthy. Cannot cringe any harder. I'm cringing, bro. I think there was a rumor that Jenk fucked animals, I think, back in the day. Yeah, okay.
Anyway, Hasan, like that one movie, squeal like a piggy, bitch. Anyway, I have some jokes as well. And Hasan, if you feel like you need to follow my white ass back to 8 Mile, just understand that Rome will likely either kill you or will, like, kidnap you and have you sign over all of the papers to your big ass house so that we own it. And then we'll sell it and build, like, you know, 5 or 6 homeless shelters in L.A. and really help with the homeless problem in L.A. It'll be like that movie Pain and Gain, except for this time it's the roided out nutless guy who can't get it up who's actually the one having everything extracted from him. So it's like a little role reversal.
What the fuck is he talking about? You know you can't build like homeless shelters in residential areas because of zoning, right? Like even if you were able to take Hasan's house, and I don't think his house, you can find his house, right? Like people had pictures of his home. We know his address. That's like public knowledge, isn't it? You could probably just look up his house. I highly doubt he has a house big enough to build 5 homeless shelters on. He lives in fucking he lives in the middle of a big city in California. There's no way his home is big enough to fit 5 homeless shelters. And even if they were able to get the home, they legally couldn't build a homeless shelter where his house is. That just isn't possible. Yeah, I want to see a tag team between this guy and Sped Gang.
So anyway, if you want to have some fun at Hasan's expense, I think we should do the Hasan Piker drinking game. If you watch his show, the best way to have a good time is just to take a shot every time he says, You'll be drunk about 90 seconds into the fucking stream, except for most of his viewers don't.
He's such a loser. He says, just drink when he says, like, bro, like, has he seen any streamer? Actually, that's it. He did it, all right? He told on himself. Because he doesn't speak to normal human beings. He doesn't speak to people. This man doesn't leave his fucking house. He doesn't speak to human beings. So he doesn't know that other people say, He doesn't. He saw Hasan do it and he noticed it. And he thinks that Hasan is like uniquely says, And that's why he's upset. Because he spends like every single day just binging Hasan videos to write more epic memes about. Bro, listen, if you want to have sex with Hasan, all right, just say that. Just say that, okay? There are lots of people every single day who horny post over Hasan. It's nothing new. Just say you want him to have sex with you. Just say that. Just say you want him to breed you. That's fine, okay? You just put it out there. Get it off your chest. They're gonna post a couple of Has mods under your post. But then you can just, like, log off and, you know, you finally gotten that off your chest and you can, like, move on, bro. Yeah, get in line, bro. Yeah, get in line. Like, okay, fine. Like, I'm sorry. I'm honestly starting to think that Hasan is some of the only content he watches now that he thinks that he uniquely says the word or like automatopoeia or whatever it's called. Can't wait for the shark drinking game. Please, no.
You'll be drunk about 90 seconds into the fucking stream.
Can I get that as a clip? I really want that. I really want that, where he makes fun of Hasan for saying and then the second he's done
except for most of his viewers they're not old enough to drink, they're underage girls, so that doesn't work for his normal viewers. But if all of us want to go watch Hasan's show and have a good time, like anybody over the age of 14 that's not a girl, then yeah, we can have a good time just drinking every time he says my man. You call yourself Hasan the Hun?
Sure, bud, appreciate it. His audience is so cringe. They're full of women and they're young and stupid. If you're not a stupid young woman, then we'll have fun. Like women. Yikes. Ew. No, dude. No, you can't do this. I know it has to be done, but I don't know if I have the strength to do it. Okay. Quality meme. It is a quality meme, I'm sorry.
You might as well just call yourself Hasan the because you are like personified. It's atrocious. That's why no one can watch his show that isn't, you know, above the age of 15.
He has a crush on Hasan, doesn't he? You don't talk about a guy like this unless you have some feelings for him. Like, let's be honest. It's still going.
But I will say, Vosh is very, very jealous of all of the underage girls that Hasan attracts to his show.
Thank you.
Yeah, basically, Hasan's entire show is just like a little piggy playing Nintendo with his hooves and going, oink, 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 Who doesn't want to watch that?
No, dude, no. I was trying to hold it in. No, no way. This is comedy. I think I'd rather watch Steven Crowder.
Have a good time is just to take a shot every time he says, you'll be drunk about 90 seconds into the fucking stream.
What a guy. This is bad. Yeah, this is bad. This is bad. Oh, you know what? I'm saving this video. I'm putting this in my watch later. When I have some friends over, I'm going to like make them watch this video, and we're going to take legal substances to get high, and I'm going to show them this video, and I want to see how they react, you know? I just want to see like the pure what their brain comes up with when faced with this sort of like absolute suffering that this video is. You're gonna give them a bad trip? Sorry.